What up, YouTube? It's Kiki Khan. I'm back at it with another video. If you're new to my channel, hey boo! For today's video, I am going to be telling you the story time of when a girl got a little too drunk. Your girl got a little too drunk. Your girl got a little, big too drunk. And she ain't know how to act. Like, take her home, pack her up. Nah, I wasn't even that bad. Like, I was just wilding, like, having fun. And being lit, being my usual lit self, because I'm such a good time. Like, let's talk about it. I'm really a great time. Like, if you ever got drunk with me, you cannot say you didn't have a good time. Like, stop playing. Like, but for my babies that understand me and that still love me, I'm gonna tell you the story time of when I fake went skinny dipping. I'm gonna be getting ready for work, so y'all gonna see me do my makeup or whatever. Just a little bit, nothing too crazy. OMG, I forgot to enhance my beauty mark. So tell me how I was in Miami for Rolling Loud 2021 back in July. Whatever. I'm on one of my friends. And you know, we was new to this Rolling Loud. Like, first of all, I was new to concerts in general. Like, I never went to a concert before. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, Rolling Loud is like a little bit strict about bottles and shit. So it's like, if you VIP, you could get away with like a small, like the mini little shots that they sell at the liquor store. But like with a big bottle, you can't. So I didn't drink, and I'm a drinker. If you know me, like, I barely smoke. But like, I will smoke on an occasion like that just so I could be lit. And like, you know what I'm saying? But I don't know. Comes to show, like, we didn't get no weed, we didn't drink because you can't bring liquor, so I would be like a little bit tipsy, but like I didn't get like crazy drunk for Rolling Loud, like, or like I didn't get like crazy high. Like, it wasn't like some crazy shit. I got high like one time because I bought this juice that had THC in it, and it was like very strong, so I was high that day. But after that, like, I wasn't high the rest of the days, and it's a 3-day experience. So I wasn't drunk. It was so much that was going on, guys. Like, basically, I barely got drunk. So here comes the last day. The last day, we're not going to Rolling Loud. Instead of, like, going to Rolling Loud for 3 days and then leaving the next day, we went to Rolling Loud for 3 days, and then we had an extra day just to chill, vibe out, and just be in South Beach and shit, like, having fun. So that last day, I was like, I'm buying my own bottle, and I'm gonna get drunk, whether y'all wanna get drunk with me or not. Like, you feel me? Like, so literally, that's literally what happened. Whether they wanted to get drunk with me or not, mission accomplished, because I got fucking drunk. And I did it by myself. Literally, by myself. I'm talking about I drank a whole bottle by myself. Now, you guys are probably like, girl, you did not drink a whole bottle of honey by yourself. Like, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? Dark liquor. But I'm not gonna tell you guys that it was my intentions. It definitely was. Nobody in their right mind would have the intention to drink a whole bottle by themselves. Like, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? That had to be some real drunk shit. Like, and people just let me do it. I don't know if that is what actually happened. I don't know if other people was taking from the bottle. Like, I don't know. But study says and sources say that I drank a whole bottle by myself. Maybe I drank most of the bottle by myself. It sounds more realistic. Like, I drank most of the bottle by myself. But I don't know. Because the way I was acting, I believe it. Listen, y'all. Listen. Like, what the fuck was wrong with me? I really want to know. Because that's really some Miami shit that I did right there. I'm talking about, like, I was taking my top off and I wanted to go skinny dipping. Thankfully, I didn't take my bottoms off, and I just showed the titties. Feel me? I got beautiful titties, so I don't mind. Like, I will show my titties, but chill. Like, it gotta be the wrong occasion. Like, I wouldn't just show it anywhere. Relax. But you know what I'm saying? Like, let's say we go to New Orleans, and we go to the Mardi Gras parade. Bitch, I'll show my titties there. Fuck, this is talking about. That's dead on my bucket list. Well, that's dead on my bucket list. You want to see my bucket list? Come on, that's dead. Let's go. All right, it doesn't say New Orleans. It doesn't say, oh, we out. It doesn't say the Mardi Gras parade, but I didn't mean to put it there. But I wanted to visit the French Quarter, and where's the Mardi Gras parade? In the French Quarter. And where's the Mardi Gras parade? In New Orleans. But back to the story. Bro, I was trying to go skinny dipping. And, you know, that's not the bad part. That's lit. Like, that's on my... It's not on my bucket list, but I'm gonna put it. It's on my mental bucket list. Something that is mentally on my bucket list is to go fucking skinny dipping. You know what I'm saying? Like, hell yeah. Like, bitch, I look good. As long as you don't record me. Yeah. Me skinny dipping is not the bad part. The bad part is that I did it in front of kids. Yo, that's never funny. No funny shit. Because I didn't even know. Like, I was so drunk that I didn't even know there was kids. You know what I'm saying? I was macking with some nigga and he took us to his crib. He had a pool and shit. And we was macking there the whole day. So basically, I was drinking from like 4 p.m. to like 11 p.m. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. When somebody told me everything that happened the next day, I was so embarrassed. And not only was I just embarrassed because that's embarrassing, but I was embarrassed because I was around some guy that I was macking with. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had just met him like when I went to Miami. That was my first time meeting him. So it was like, okay, bad first impressions, but it is what it is. That's me, bitch. So in my head, I'm like, yo, this nigga is not gonna fuck with me after this. But then in my head, I'm also like, I mean, I'm really a dope ass person. And, you know, shit happens. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm young. Like, I still got a lot to learn. So I was just like, if he don't fuck with me, like, okay, his loss. You know what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, like, it's shit that I learned from. And I'm not gonna sit here and be like, oh yeah, I regret acting like that. Like, yeah, I kind of regret drinking that much. But, like, you know what I'm saying? Everything that happened, it happened, and I'ma learn from it. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's nothing to stress over. Trust me. That guy was really vibing, and he was still with me after that. Cause I ended up, like, I got so drunk that I went to his crib and I slept in his crib, and I had a flight at 8 a.m. It was like 5. I woke up at like 5 a.m. Like, what the fuck? I haven't even packed. Like, I need to leave. Type shit. Like, it was crazy. So I ended up changing my flight because I was not doing all that. I didn't even pack. I didn't really sleep. I was so lit. Like, if the flight was like 150 to change, I'm like, whatever, I'm changing this shit. I'ma just mac out for another day and relax and, you know, get my shit together so I could leave peacefully and not leave on a, like, in a rush like that. Like, that's just weird. Feel me? So yeah, like, I understand. He actually chilled with me the last day too. But then after that, you know, he didn't really fuck with me like that. But it's okay. Cause, so you're like a tebuena. All right, you guys, I am done getting ready. My hair is done, face is done, ready to go to work. And that is about that. So basically, like, that's what happened. And that's just another one of my crazy ass stories and shit that I've been through, like, real life shit. Like, listen, I don't know if other people be going through shit like this, but, like, listen, like, my life is crazy. My life is really a movie. Like, I could really make a movie out of my life, and it'll be so entertaining because, like, yo, should that be happening? And it's like, it's embarrassing, and it's like, damn, I don't want that to happen again, but it was a good story to tell. That is about that for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, and share. And if you enjoyed this video, hit that bell notification button so you won't miss another one.